Ladies and gentlemen, this is an urgent message sent by the Creator of the heavens and all earth, declaring unto you the warning that is being given to all of God's creation, and a warning concerning your evil actions. This is a warning to you and your children. This is the iniquities that they have committed against the Lord of hosts. This is also a warning concerning the past sins introduced by the parents of them, which have now increased in them. You have forgotten the ways of God. You have turned away from God. You who live against the Most High God, you must come to correction. In your sin you have angered him and despised his counsels. In times past, God has watched how you hurl all evils upon those who have been sent by the Lord Jesus Christ. You have not obeyed his law. You have chosen rebellion against the Most High God. How long shall God endure your rebellious ways? How long shall you keep to your sin and not repent? Why do you turn your faces away from the one who died on the cross, the one who died for you, the only one God has sent? This day, the mighty God has commanded his watchmen to come into your towns and cities and declare unto you that it is God himself who has given you life. It is God himself who has provided light for you. God has done great wonders among many of you. Yet you have turned to money, idols and mortal men, and have forgotten the ways of the mighty God. Whoever makes a practice of sinning is of the devil, for the devil has been sinning from the beginning. The reason the Son of God appeared was to destroy the works of the devil. No one born of God makes a practice of sinning, for God's seed abides in him, and he cannot keep on sinning because he has been born of God. By this it is evident who are the children of God, and who are the children of the devil. Whoever does not practice righteousness is not of God, nor is the one who does not love his brother. Thus says the Lord, I brought my people out of bondage and I given them commandments through my servants the prophets, but they would not listen to them. In your sin and rebellion you have made God's counsels void in your hearts. God has brought many of you up with gladness. God has blessed your nation. But you have turned your faces away, and will not listen anymore, and because you have chosen sin before the Lord God, and have done what is evil in his sight. The Lord this day is calling upon all of you to repent of your wickedness. You have not kept the word of God in your hearts. Each of you have made an agreement with sin in your hearts, and so now God is calling upon you to repent before judgment be upon your heads. This is a kind of judgment that cannot be washed away. Repent before confusion is brought upon all of you, and bring all of you who live in sin to ruin. The people of this land who conceal the unrighteous within them. O you wicked and stiff-necked nation, have you not known what God did to Sodom and Gomorrah, whose land lies in lumps of pitch and heaps of ashes? This is what the Creator of the heavens and all earth will do to those who have not listened to him, says the Lord Almighty. Remember this day for those who are living. God is calling you. God is calling you out of sin. God is calling you to repent of your evil ways, for there is only but one that can save you. God is calling you to turn to him. Turn to Jesus Christ. Life is in him. Turn to Jesus Christ. He is the truth. Turn to Jesus Christ. He is the life. Turn to Jesus Christ or you will die in your sin. He is the only way for you to live. For you pass from this world like locusts and your life is like a mist, but you are not worthy to obtain mercy on your own, for the Lord God has strictly commanded those who have came into this world when they came what they should do to live and what they should observe to avoid the eternal punishment. Nevertheless, many of you are still not obedient. You think highly of yourself and still you speak against God. The people who have rose up before you have devised for themselves vain thoughts against you and proposed to themselves wicked frauds. Your leaders before you have even declared that the Creator of the heavens and all earth does not exist, and you believed them. They have told you that God is not real, but yet have taught you how to create your own gods and live against the one true God, who is the only Creator. They have taught you how to ignore God's ways, and this is why you do not know God. This is why you do not live for God, and this is why you do not know God's word. You are taught to scorn God's law. You are taught to deny all of his commandments. That is the reason that empty things are for the empty and full things are for the full. The Most High God, Jesus Christ, the only one who dwells above the earth, has made this world for the sake of many, but the world to come for the sake of only a few. When you ask the earth, it will tell you that it provides a large amount of clay from which earthenware is made, but only a little dust from which gold comes. So is the course of the present world. Many have been created, but only a few shall be saved. For not of your own choice did you come into the world, and against your desire you will depart. For you have been given only a short of amount time to live, and it shall be that all who will be saved will be by the name that is above every name, and that name is Jesus Christ. Those who live for Christ will be able to escape the coming judgment on account of their devotion to Jesus Christ. On the account of repentance of their sins and the account of their faith in God, by which they have believed in the one whom he has sent. As many as did not acknowledge the Most High God in their lifetime, though they received his benefits, and as many as scorned his laws while they still had freedom, but did not understand them, and despised them while an opportunity of repentance was still open to them, these must in torment acknowledge it after death. Therefore do not continue to be curious about why this message is being played, or about how the ungodly will be punished, but go now before the Lord Jesus Christ and inquire on how you can be saved, those to whom the age belongs and for whose sake the age was made. This is the message that has been sent by the kingdom of the Most High: you who are in sin, you who are living in total rebellion towards the Most High God, this is your warning. This message is being made clear and public to the people of this nation, and this is the warning to all of you who are in unbelief. Now is the time to return back to the Lord of hosts. The watchmen have been sent out to deliver this warning that disaster is coming for those who live in sin. Disaster is near, disaster is near, disaster is coming and is on the horizon for those who deny Jesus Christ. For those who live in wickedness, the message is being made clear to you right now: repent of your sin and return back to the Most High God, or you will not be exempt from the judgment. He is bringing the judgment that is at hand. This is the judgment that is soon coming and will not be delayed. The wickedness of the people has reached the kingdom of heaven, and God will not tolerate your sin. God will not ignore your sin. Repent of your sin, turn away from your sin, believe in Jesus Christ. Jesus is coming. The judge is coming. Turn back to Christ while you still have time.